again. I'm joined by Paul Welch, CEO of SDX Energy today. First of all, Paul, happy new year to you. Thanks for joining us. Do update us on what's happening in Morocco.
Okay, thanks very much. Happy new year to you as well. So in Morocco, we've had some recent success. You know, we've drilled the KSR 14, 15, and 16, all of which have been successes. And so we've, as I think we've discussed in the past, we've recently flow tested those wells.
And when will we get the flow test results?
So on 14 and 15, we reported those to the market, and those have been, you know, between 6 and 7 million cubic feet a day each per individual well. As I think everyone that's watching us probably knows, we're selling at the moment only 6 million cubic feet a day of gas in Morocco. So individually, either one of those wells could make our total daily requirement. So it's pretty encouraging for new sales. KSR 16, which was the third well we drilled, we're going to complete here. It's been connected to the sales system, and we're going to complete it essentially early part of next week, and then we'll flow test that. That well had some of the best pay that we've seen so far in the system, so we expect that the rate on that one will be pretty, it'll be comparable, if not slightly more, than what we've had in the past. And then today, we also reported out on our extension for the Lalla Mimouna expiration concession, where we've got got another 4 months on that extension.
Yeah, I understand work due to start there in March, you were saying earlier. Is that now changed?
No, the work is going to continue in March. The issue that we had is that the concession is also due to expire in March. So with the wells being drilled in March, we wanted some time to evaluate the results before we had to make a quick decision on extending it into the next phase or not. So these are the last two wells in our current 9-well program. And they'll be drilled towards the end of the program. So we expect to drill those in March. And so we needed some time post completion of those wells to determine, you know, what the way forward for the concession would be. So the ministry has granted us an additional 4 months, which is fantastic. It's more than enough time to evaluate the results.
Great to hear you reporting successes on the wells that you've drilled. Of course, sometimes wells don't work. And when that happens, you have to make sensible decisions.
That's true. And so I'm sure you're alluding to our ELQ1 well that we reported on today.
I am.
So ELQ was our fourth well in the program. And unfortunately, it was not successful. We encountered good quality sands like on our other wells, but only 2 meters of it were hydrocarbon bearing. We didn't think that was sufficient commercially to justify the completion. So we're going to plug abandon this well. This well was one of the two wells that we added to the program. From its initial expectations, we originally had a 7-well program. We added 2 wells to it. This was one of the two. And the reason that we added this well to the program is that it was adjacent it was in a new concession called the RARB Center, which was adjacent to our existing infrastructure. The well had a pad already completed on it. It had 3D over it that was shot by a previous operator. And so the idea behind this well is that the type of 3D they acquired was low resolution 3D. And we're typically acquire high resolution 3D. So we wanted to see if this low res would work. And if it worked, then we could essentially downscale our program and save a little bit of money. So we drilled this well to test that concept. It doesn't work from our perspective. So we're going to continue on with our high res program. So it was a bit of a lesson learned from this. So you know, we're glad we drilled the well. It was important to test the concept. The concept has now been tested. And so the next 3 development locations that we're going to drill are all based on our data, high res. We're pretty confident that the structures are there. And then we move on to the 2 exploration wells. So we don't expect this pattern to be repeated on our next wells.
All that success taken into account, Paul, going forward into 2018, give us an idea of your gas sales ambitions. You alluded to it earlier. What is the supply-demand deficit that you're handling?
So at the moment, you know, we have a pipeline, an 8-inch pipeline that can handle 24 million cubic feet a day of gas. We are currently selling about 6. So that means we have 18 million cubic feet a day of ullage. And so our objective is to fill that up. So, you know, we initiated this Project Bancatra, Project 24, with the government to fill up that pipeline. When we went out and did a survey of the demand locally where we sell our gas, we found that there was 44 million cubic feet demand of capacity out there. So there is as much as we can find, we can sell. And so our ambitions for 2018 are to essentially take our production up by 50% and be selling 10 million cubic feet a day of gas by the end of 2018. We hope to move it forward into the the early part of the year, but it'll depend on customer connections. But we expect by the end of 2018 to be selling at least 10 million cubic feet a day of gas.
And is that not just practically possible, practicably, I should say, possible in terms of the fields and the wells themselves, but also working with the Moroccan government? How are you finding that? Is it something that seems possible to you?
It's more than possible. Our Moroccan partner, so we're 75% all of our concessions, and our partner is the state, which is 25%. So we work with them on a daily basis. I can say that they are fantastic to work with. We work with a lot of host governments. They are one of the best to work with, so we're happy there. So it's more than practical. It's very likely. It's highly likely. So when I say we can do 10, there is no holdback. There's only support from the government on making that happen. So the government is not an impediment here. The only thing that's slowing us down is just the connection to the end customer. The demand is there. We just have to essentially lay new line, put in some metering skids, and then connect up and go. So we're very confident that we can do at least 10 million in 2018.
Paul Welch, great to talk to you. Come back and talk to us again soon.
All right. Thank you very much. And again, Happy New Year.
Thank you.